All right, here we are for round two. We're on the draw, and yeah, this looks like a keep to me. Kind of unfortunate that we'll have to suspend this on turn one, but whatever. It's no big deal. Be nicer to draw it on turn three and cast it off Yhenny's expertise. Okay, looks like we're probably playing against Dredge, which is gonna be tough. Certainly very tough game one. Alright. I guess I would rather hold up Spell Snare than do anything else. Being able to counter a potential Cathartic Reunion is really big. So also our opponent kind of bricked on Dredgers here. So that's something. Loam? I mean, it's not totally worth countering, but it's not not worth countering either. It's not nothing. Yeah, maybe we can constrain them on mana, so it's worth countering. Hold up Remand here for the Faithless Looting Flashback. Probably a good plan. Ooh, they have Scourge Devil, so they can flash this back, which will get back both the amalgams and hit us pretty hard. But I will remand Faithless Looting if they have that, for sure. Okay, so they have a land. Yeah, they're just going with the Unearth and Bash. So we'll play Tar Pit, pass, and then we'll Expertise plus Ancestral next turn. And we can remand again. Ooh, double Blood Gas. That's annoying. And we know they have a Dackmoor Salvage, too. And this Loam is going to get them plenty of lands. So is it worth countering the Loam? I think it is because it stops them from getting a fetch, which is actually really meaningful. Because they could just chill with a fetch and play and all these blood ghasts. So, which would get them back the amalgams right away. So that's an important thing to be aware of. But this is obviously still not going to go very well for us. Oh my goodness, our hand is bad. Well, game one of this matchup is going to be almost unwinnable no matter what we did, so. That is what it is, I suppose. Yeah, I don't. Actually, we just literally die here because he'll get back two Blood Ghasts, which will have haste and hit us down to six and then conflagrate us for seven. So that'll do it. Or conflagrate us for six because he has to play a land. Alright, so sideboarding. Leyline is definitely great. Liliana's definitely awful. Victim of Night is pretty bad. I think Countersquall is probably okay. Not great, but okay. Dispel doesn't really do anything. Fulminator seems medium. I could imagine games in which it's good. I'm not sure if the expertise is any good. It's probably not great. Thoughtseize is also probably not great, but we have a lot of bad cards. We're kind of leaning heavily on Leyline here. I guess maybe just Dispel for Nature's Claim and board out like two Fatal Push or two Expertise. I'll board out two Fatal Push. All right, yeah, let's give this a try. All right, here we are for game two. We get to go first. No Leyline, no thank you. Wow, really keep drawing those Fatal Pushes. Yeah, I'm just gonna go until we get a Leyline. All right. Keep it. That's a win condition. We'll keep that and do that and hope that this goes well. Right, that's not a Nature's Claim yet. That's a weird sideboard card. All right, well, we have a Tar Pit, so we can attack. Yeah, Thoughtseize was not something I was expecting to play against out of Dredge. Okay. I guess we might as well just Thought Scour them. We can cast Tasker if we draw it anyway, so there's no reason to Thought Scour ourselves, really. And I would like to see more of how our opponent's sideboarded. Wow, that's a lot of Thoughtseize. I guess he thought our graveyard hate was going to be like Ravenous Trap or something. Okay, Cathartic Reunion is fine. Well, if they have Nature's Claim in their deck, they'll be digging to it pretty quickly, but Creeping Tar Pit does actually hit pretty hard. And they're also just basically out of amalgams at this point, which is pretty nice. Crunch. Yeah, so I don't feel very troubled unless they manage to have a Nature's Claim, but even still, they're going to be so slow. Yeah, all right. I guess I just had no way to beat Leyline on a Mold 4, so that's good for us. That will not be true of the next game, so we should try to sideboard somewhat accordingly. Although I don't think there's much to change. Could board out these Fatal Pushes for like Fulminators, which I think will have its moments, but generally not be great. So I'll try it. Yeah, I like the rest of these cards as much as was going to like any card in this matchup. So yeah, let's give this a try. All right, here we are for game two with a 7-card hand that contains Leyline of the Void, so we'll keep it. It's probably going to get destroyed, but if it doesn't, we have Dispel. So, yeah, this is definitely a dead Leyline, no question about it. It was kind of predictable given that our opponent kept 7 too after losing to Leyline. But we can actually cast another one in this deck, so that there is something to be said for that. They have Neonate? Oh, they don't have a Dredger. Excellent. Oh, and there's another Leyline for us. Okay. So I'm gonna Thought Scour now, because we might draw a Tasigur or an Inquisition or something. We did not, so we'll just play Delta and pass. Yeah, we can't counter that. So they get a Bloodghast back, but still no Dredger. So things are not going horribly. They chose not to Bloodghast because they're going to keep digging for prized amalgams. Okay, that makes sense. They found a Stinkweed Imp to put in their graveyard. So we'll go ahead and fetch. And nothing good. So we'll just play Swamp and pass. We have Snapcaster Thought Scour available. Our opponent is also going to fetch so they can get their Bloodghast back. But they don't actually have a Loam going yet or anything like that. They are going to get to flashback looting. Oh, they chose not to return Bloodghast again, so that must mean they have more lands in hand because they're going to dredge Stinkweed Imp for sure. So now they get two Bloodghasts. Well, a Yhenny's Expertise would be really good. Can't do anything about this Faithless Looting. And there's going to be two prized amalgams. So yeah, a Yhenny's Expertise would really seal this game up for us. But we do have to survive long enough for it. I mean, it looks like we'll survive at least one more turn. So yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and Snapcaster back Thought Scour. They get back two amalgams. Again, they chose not to return blood gas. Very interesting. Okay, Tasigur's good. We could even Thought Seize them here, but I think just playing Leyline of the Void is probably much better. The only reason to play Thought Seize is if we're worried about an additional Nature's Claim, which is a possibility, but it looks like a reality. No, maybe not. So now they're getting the blood gas back. We'll just pass, then we can trade for a blood ghast. They can still dredge stuff, but it doesn't obviously doesn't help them fill their graveyard. And probably don't have a Nature's Claim because they didn't upkeep a Nature's Claim, which they certainly would have if they could have. So yeah, we'll just block Blood Ghast and take our beatdowns. And then we can Ancestral ourselves and hope to draw out of this mess. We will have Dispel for Nature's Claim after this turn. And so there's no Nature's Claims coming. That's good. Expertise, please. No such luck. All right. Guess I'll just play a basic and play Tasigur, removing all of the non-expertise cards from my graveyard. And now we're actually not dying also. Well, we're not dead this turn. Could have cast Thought Seize, but I think that getting to activate Tasigur and hoping to flip two lands is pretty good. Take nine here down to two. It's another reason, I suppose, to not cast Thought Seize. Sure, Loam resolves. Cathartic Reunion. Yeah, I guess that resolves too. So Snapcaster would be really good here. Yeah, I guess that resolves as well. So yeah, if we hit a combination of Snapcaster and lands here, that would be great. Oh, Fulminator, unlucky. All right, well, I guess our best bet is to Thought Scour ourselves and hope to get lucky. Counter Squall. Oh, there was a Snapcaster. Rats. Well, I think we're dead. That's too bad. So let's see, we can play Fulminator, block this, block this. Now we're super dead. Yeah, well, that's a really bad matchup, so there you have it. Also, yeah, this deck's a work in progress. I probably should have boarded in the third expertise, actually. Oh well. We'll be back for round three. Yeah.